Avocado oil has become increasingly popular, but what are the health effects of consuming avocado oil? Do we have any science on it? Avocado oil is a source of mainly healthy fats, with the main component being monounsaturated fats, specifically oleic acid, which is a monounsaturated fat and is also the main fat found in olive oil. The rest of the fat in avocado oil is split roughly 50-50 between polyunsaturated fats at an average of about 13%, and saturated fats at about 11 to 12%. This breakdown, this nutrient composition, is quite similar to olive oil, pretty close, with slightly less saturated fat and a bit more polyunsaturated fat in avocado oil. Avocado oil is also a rich source of things like tocopherols, polyphenols, and phytosterols, which can have a host of health benefits, including antioxidant and anti-inflammatory effects. Another promising characteristic of avocado oil is a high smoke point. So the smoke point is the temperature at which an oil starts burning, and you want to avoid that. And avocado oil is reported to have a high smoke point of about 250 Celsius. That's for unrefined avocado oil. For refined avocado oil, it's even higher, sometimes 270 or even higher, which puts avocado oil among the oils with the highest smoke point. Bear in mind, there is some variation. I've seen studies reporting a smoke point around 200, some reporting even lower. So it depends on the type of avocado and also how it's processed. Interestingly, one study found that the heat stability of avocado oil is very similar to olive oil, at least at a moderate temperature, 180 Celsius, so not super high. Another thing that surprised me going through the evidence is I found very few studies giving people avocado oil and looking at the health effects. I did find a couple though. One trial found that avocado oil increased the absorption of fat-soluble nutrients from salsa or salad, things like carotenoids or lycopene that also have an antioxidant effect. And both the avocado fruit and avocado oil were equally effective at increasing absorption. Another study compared avocado oil to butter, and it found that the folks consuming the avocado oil had improved blood metrics after a meal. For example, they had lower insulin levels, lower glucose, lower total cholesterol, LDL cholesterol, triglycerides, and the inflammatory marker C-reactive protein. Now, this trial was really small, and it only looked at these acute changes right after a meal. So it'll be interesting to see in the future if this pans out long-term for fasting measures over time. So the information we have so far, both in terms of nutrient composition and the few studies we have in humans, suggest that avocado oil is probably a healthy fat and a good choice to cook, for example, and hopefully we'll get more studies in the future and have more information. Now, if you do decide to buy avocado oil, which type should you go for? There's basically four grades of avocado oil in the market: extra virgin, virgin, pure, and mix, or blended. So what are these exactly? How are they produced? This may surprise you. Extra virgin avocado oil is produced from high-quality fruit, and it's extracted just with mechanical methods, so it's cold-pressed, under 50 degrees centigrade, without chemical solvents. Virgin avocado oil is extracted the same way, same methods, but the fruit is a little lower quality. It can have small areas of rot and some physical changes. And then the pure avocado oil is actually refined. Any quality fruit can be used for it. It is often bleached and deodorized. It's infused with natural flavor of herbs or fruits, and the extraction process sometimes uses heat and hexane. And finally, the mixed or blended kind is basically combined with other oils like olive oil or canola oil. Unfortunately, we don't have much science on the health effects of each kind of avocado oil, but this lets you know what you're buying. What other kinds of fats would you like me to look at? Let me know below in the comments. Here's a video on olive oil and all its health effects, and here's one on canola oil and the impact that has on your body. Check those out. I'll see you in there. Bye-bye.